The world beneath the waves shimmered with mystery. Glowkelp bulbs lit up around her as she passed by. Erin spotted some odd-looking old coins. Maybe her father would know where they were from. An eerie light flickered and danced on the seafloor, like an underwater fire. Her father once told her about a mysterious, living energy called Tyne. Could that have been a Tyne wellspring? A seahorse, made of clockwork gears, darted out of the way as Merin approached. She wondered who could have built such a curious creature. Merin approached a glowing scrap of metal and pulled it inside. It was claw-shaped and had a strong magnetic pull. She took out her tools and attached it to a firing mechanism on her steering column. Erin spotted shock nettles ahead of her. She had to be cautious, as the hostile creatures would attack her on sight. A sleeping guardian blocked Merrin's path. She knew it all too well from her father's stories, and she knew it must never be woken. From a bad dream. For a moment, she thought she had experienced her own death, but it had merely been the Tyne showing her one of the many possible roads ahead. According to her father, the Guardians had been built by ancient undersea explorers called the Fomori. Merrin always thought the Fomori were a myth. Now she wondered if her father's other stories might be true. The old statue reminded her of her father's lullabies about the brave and beautiful Merrows. Yasmeren explored, she sketched the terrain on a sheet of cartography paper. Her father had taught her that those who make maps are never lost. A huge hermit crab watched Meryn from a rocky ledge. On his back, he carried a vast array of odd-looking treasures. The crab seemed to like shiny objects. Maybe he would be willing to make a trade. The powerful current was too strong to cross. Meryn's submarine would need greater thrust before it could go back. clams were notoriously picky eaters. Each one seemed to prefer a different kind of treat.
Thank you.
Amidst the wreckage of an old Fomori vessel lay an undamaged propulsion device. Meryn bolted it onto the back of her submarine, eager to test out its effects on her lightweight craft.